Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I will be talking about our Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Prophet Muhammad was born on the 17th of Rabiul Awal in the year of the elephants in the city of Mecca. His father's name was Abdullah and his mother's name was Amina bint Wahab. His father died before he was born and his mother left this world when the Holy Prophet was very young. So he was looked after by Abdul Muttalib, his grandfather. After his grandfather died, he was cared and looked after by his uncle, Abu Talib, who was also the father of Imam Ali alayhi salam. The Holy Prophet married Bibi Khadija and had one son who died in his infancy and one daughter who we all know was Bibi Fatima. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Holy Quran to Prophet Muhammad through Angel Jibreel. The first ayat to be revealed were the first five ayahs of Surah Alaq, the 96th surah in the Holy Quran, which reads, "Read, in the name of your Lord who created you from a clot of blood. Read, your Lord is the most generous, who taught by the pen, taught man what he did not know." Prophet Muhammad was known as As-Sadiq, the truthful. He had a reputation of being trustworthy, and the people of Mecca would entrust their valuables to the Prophet. He was also known as Rahmatul Lil Alameen, which means the mercy to mankind. He was always kind and gentle and had very good akhlaq. This is how he spread Islam through his beautiful manners and is an example for us every day to follow in his footsteps. Be truthful in whatever we do and have good manners, even when people are not very kind to us. A story comes to mind when our Holy Prophet used to pass a particular place where a lady would throw rubbish on him. When one day he passed, there was no rubbish thrown on him. He inquired and went to see if she was okay. She thought he had come to seek revenge, but instead he asked if she was well and prayed for her. The lady was amazed and very ashamed of her actions and asked if she could accept the religion he followed. The Holy Prophet spread Islam for 23 years. He faced a lot of trials and hardships, but always had faith in the Almighty and never gave up. This teaches us that if we want something, we have to strive and try our utmost best and not give up faith in Allah. And inshallah, if it is good for us, we will surely get it. The Prophet had a very caring nature and always helped people who were in need. There is another story where once the Holy Prophet saw a slave grinding some grain on a grinding mill driven by hand. As he grounded the grains, he was crying. On seeing this, the Prophet became anxious. He asked the slave the reason why he was weeping. The slave said, "I am sick. I cannot grind the grain. My master is very cruel and he will beat me up if I cannot finish my job." At this, the Prophet stepped forward and ground the rest of the grain, saying, Always call me if you have grain to grind. I will do it for you." Subhanallah, what wonderful examples we have in history that we can learn from and use in our lives. And inshallah, we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are able to follow in the footsteps of Rasulullah and the A'imma to attain closeness to Allah. In Muharram 10 AH, after having performed his Hajj and the event of Ghadir, the Holy Prophet fell ill with a severe fever and sadly left this world on the 28th of Safar at the age of 63. This was a very sad time for the whole Muslim Ummah as they had lost a wonderful leader and guide. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.